is we're only like 2 or 3 days away now, potentially getting the game for the EA Play trial on Wednesday. I wanted to cover a couple more No Money Spent things before then. Unless we get some more information or a Mutt database, we'll probably wait until the game actually comes out to have another video for you guys. But the 5 most important things you can do as a No Money Spent player. Let's go.
If you're looking to build the best team in Madden, make sure you head over to MMOEXP.com. Link is in the description below right now. Make sure you use code CC for 5% off the cheapest coins, the fastest delivery, everything you can need to be on your road to greatness. Again, use code CC, 5% off.
Here comes the money.
Here we go. Money talk.
Here comes the money.
Smiling in the mirror as you're practicing my wrist flick. I can't settle for a quarter real fast. Need a bare maximum. Word to Khalil Mack. War so ambitious. Oh, God.
Hey, what is going on, Madden family? We are back, and it is No Money Spent discussion time. Now, if you are new to the channel, please make sure you are subscribed. Like I said, Madden 22 is just a couple days away. And make sure you drop a like on the video. Again, I'd like to see 500 on the video. Maybe we get there. Maybe we don't. It's still before the game. So if we don't, that's fine. But we are talking about the most important things we can do No Money Spent. And that's not even just right now at launch. This is throughout the whole year. Okay? Now, if we're not spending any money, we are going to be spending time on the game. And that is the most important thing that we want to mitigate and manage for us. So I'm going to talk about some stuff. We're obviously going to be looking here at Madden 21 for some points within here and the key points I want to bring up. And the first point that I always have found when being No Money Spent, no matter if your coin stack is little or it's big, you know, it just depends on, you know, how much time you're putting into the game. But to me, the first thing you always want to do is don't rush to buy things. Okay. Now there are going to be chances and times throughout the year where stuff is going to be really, really cheap. And that's more based on when promos come out, when stuff really drops, gifts during the Zero Chill or Christmas promo, right? Stuff like that. Those prices always really, really plummet. Otherwise, what I'm really talking about here are the starts of big promos and legends, right? Now, you can complete this stuff or get these cards. And what I'm saying by immediately, I mean like really, really quickly, right? So if a new legend drops, don't go buying it immediately. Wait a week. Maybe you wait 2 weeks. It's not going to be all that different. And you're going to save an absolute ton of coins. Even if you are super stacked on coins, that is fine. Additionally, when a promo comes out, sometimes those MasterCards, they're at a pretty low price. They'll probably still go down. There's going to be a lot more content for these promos. Stuff always drops. Again, just be patient with it. Okay? Now, on the flip side of that, like we said, if there's gifts or something that come out or something that really drops the price, maybe a fan appreciation pack or something like that, it's totally okay to go ahead and buy what you want at that point because the price is going to be pretty low. And that's always our goal, is to buy something at the lowest price for something that we're going to use. Because again, we're playing the game. That is the point for me when I'm building my team, is to actually play the game. Right, number 2 for us is taking advantage of the free stuff, whatever that may be. Now, again, with the caveat, as we are No Money Spent here, we have to spend time. Some of the stuff that we get is not worth our time. Maybe it's house rules, rewards, or something like that. That takes a long time. And if you're just trying to play the game, sure, go for it, right? But what I mean more are some of these solo challenges that we get. Now, maybe this changes this year. Maybe it's a lot more objective-based, which is how it looked. But if we go through some of these, were super good, right? And then some of them were not. If the reward's really, really good, then maybe, you know, maybe you take your time on it, right? But let's take a look as we have to go all the way down here to Team Builders Series 1. This is for an 84 overall non-auctionable team builder, and it was 16 full games. 16 full games for an 84. That's not really worth my time. On the flip side, Superstar MVPs. Right, you were able to get an 85 to 86 overall nat card for 135 stars. And the good thing with solos like this sometimes is you can sort of pick and choose your way. And these are a lot easier requirements to get some stars. Score a touchdown, right? Stuff like that. Score a passing touchdown, 3 passes. Again, this is a much better use of our time here. So this is what I mean. Take advantage of what's free out there. But playing a 16 game full string of solos for an 84 really just is not worth my time. Now, of course, you're going to be able to get some stats done for other stuff. And I think that this is going to be changing a bit this year. And I hope it does, because that's kind of absurd. And most of the solo strings or challenges that we get are going to be very easy for us. But remember, when we see some of those and you're like, ah, that's a lot of work, it's okay not to have that card. Unless you really, really want it, it's okay, because you can always make coins doing other things. All right, number three on our list is knowing when to buy and knowing when to sell. Again, this is super cyclical, and this is really more based on the timing of packs and how good packs are. Generally, the best time to buy non-legend cards is on Saturdays when there's Legend Fantasy packs, Ultimate Legend Fantasy packs, right? But there's also a best time to sell stuff that you pull, or even if you're doing a minor investment on cards. Normally, the buy day is Saturday, the sell day is Wednesday. That's historical data. That's just normally how it goes. Now, at the beginning of the game, things are kind of going to go up and down a bit. We don't really know how the structure and the flow of content is going to be. But generally, that is indeed the case, right? And especially early on, if training is something that you really need, training is going to be kind of cheap on day one, and then it's going to rise over time. And that general rise of training is what's going to keep most of these cards at their price points, right? But like I said, if you go in and find the historical data of buying cards on Saturday, selling them on Wednesday, generally you can make a profit. Not always. Maybe a full new legend? Maybe not, right? The price is probably going to go down. But some of those other cards, maybe it's an 87 Tyreek Hill. Maybe you can get them for 225 on a Saturday and sell them for 275 on a Wednesday. After taxes, that's 30,000 coins. That's not bad. That buys you an 84 for your team. Oh, okay, cool. But again, this takes coins to make coins, okay? Again, if you're really, really smart, anything that's new and has a really high price, you pull packs, let's just say you pull packs with coins, you want to sell. You pull a brand new legend or something like that, you want to sell that card, right? But if you pull an older card and you want to get your max return on it, generally selling later on in the week is a good thing. And like I said, Wednesday is normally the case, but keep an eye on the market especially. And if you are holding on to cards that you've pulled or invested in, you'll want to check the auction block daily to see if the price point is where you want it to be. Plus, also, if you are buying cards to invest, again, those short 5-day turnarounds, all you got to do, pull out a piece of paper, get an Excel spreadsheet, write the card down, and write what you paid for it, just so you know. You know what your break-even point is after tax, then gives you a much better understanding of, are you making coins, losing coins, or breaking even. Number four is when we are selling off our teams. Now, I don't normally mean we're going to sell off every card on our team, because some of the cards, the value is going to be stagnant at times. Sometimes people like to sell before promos. It's really hard to really know how promos are going to work. And this is something we will revisit as the year goes on for sure. Once we get a better idea of the cadence and again, the structure and the flow of the content for us. But what I have done a lot, and I did a lot last year, was selling my team off before series updates. Now, it doesn't really sound like we're going to have series this year. Maybe we still do. Sounds like it's more season based. And what that normally would bring, and we're going to assume brings, is obviously the reduxes and higher pack odds, right? So if you can take some cards that have a decent value, you can sell them before the switch. Maybe you'll be able to buy those same cards back at a discount. And if you're going to do that, you're going to have to buy those cards back pretty quickly. If seasons or series update on Friday, normally you're going to want to buy those cards back on that Friday kind of quickly, but sometimes it does not work out that way. There is risk involved in this, but you can be smart about it and you can understand it based on the content that is coming up. Every single time we have a season or series update coming, I will let you guys know exactly what I am doing. Now, for me, who likes to play weekend league, obviously I can't sell my team over the weekend, but once I finish weekend league, I will normally purge my team slightly from some of these more expensive cards, knowing that I don't necessarily need them for the week. If I'm not planning on playing the seasons games or anything for the week, then I can come back the next weekend and purchase them as well. Again, just hoping for the right price point. It's all about maximizing our coins here, and I think this is helpful, but we want to make sure that this is the way it is indeed going to be. So make sure you tune back in whenever that first season changes. I believe it's right at the start of October, and I will let you guys know exactly what I am doing 100%. And the last thing is number five here, and this kind of ties into our first point of, like, don't go buy something really, really fast, you know? But it's the truth. And what I want you to know and realize is, like, it's okay to not have the best of the best team. Even for someone like myself, who did very well with their coins, played a lot, won a lot of games, I never really had the best team. And it's kind of a fallacy out there that you need the best team to compete. Now, it does help. Don't get me wrong. I think the team does play a factor and stuff, but it's okay. Don't get that sort of jealousy or have that need like, oh, I really need to go get this card. There is no card that is going to come out based on the cost that is going to make you more coins than it's going to cost you. It does not happen. Okay. There's a million coin card. You know how hard it is to get a million coins back? Instead, what you want to do, instead of worrying about that time of, oh, I can't have this card. Oh, they have a better team than me. Go ahead and work the market. Right? The reason I'm not really talking about the market a lot in this video, and I haven't, is because at this point we haven't seen how the price ranges are really going to work and affect things. So I don't want to put a lot of that out there. There is always ways to work the market. Don't get jealous of other people's teams. Don't worry about not having the best card at every position or even the best card at a few positions. It's fine. I want you guys to know that and understand that, because we're playing a longer term game as a no money spent player. Whereas a lot of people who spend money on the game, that's kind of a shorter term thing, right? Not necessarily they don't play for a long time, but they're obviously getting that real quick gratification by getting the new players or adding new players to the team and all that. Can't worry about that too much, because there's going to be moments in the year when the heavy money spent players and the no money spent players, that gap's going to close between the teams because of the content that drops, the free stuff that's out there, and the value of cards. Normally, Christmas time is probably going to be the best bet. But be great. Take care. I hope this helps you guys out. Again, we will be covering absolutely every single step of the way for me this year on No Money Spent on this channel. But thank you guys for your support, and we'll catch you guys later. I'm out. Peace.